Hello friends, welcome back to our packet tracer series. Today we are going to discuss about router modes. So let's start. Before going router mode, I already explained what is router in our previous video. So before going to our router mode, I will just give a small introduction about router. What is router and how it work and all this one. A small thing, then we will go to router modes. So let's start. This one, what is router? I will ask you a question, what is router? If you know the answer, just try to write in the comments, what is router? I will review and I will reply to your comments also. So write, what is router? Now I will give the answer. A router is a device which used to make communication between two different network. But whatever answer you have in your mind, try to keep in the comments. I will try to read. I am giving as a basic general definition about router function. Router is a device which used to make communication between two different network, and it is a layer three device used to forward the packet from one network to another network. This is also one more definition. It forward the packet through one of its port based on the destination IP address and entry in the routing table. What is routing table? And this we are going to learn in our next video, coming videos, because here just we are giving the introduction about the router and the modes. Next video we will have routing protocol as well as the routing table and all this one. Now just remember, routing table is a table which router is going to maintain inside the router. And it will record the best path of the network. So whenever any packet need to transfer from one path to another path, router will look the routing table and he will transmit. Example, I will draw one scenario here. Try to look here. Example, this is router one and we have router two and we have router three. Here this is router three. And here is router 4 and here is router 5. This is a 5 router and this is connected like this and this is connected like this also. So router, if packet is going to be packet we are transmitting from router 1 to router 5, router, it is having two path. One is he can go from here, the packets can move from the router 1 to router 2, 3 and 5 from here, or one another path is it will go from here. Depending upon the routing protocol, it will decide. Example, if we take the RIP will count the hop count, means how many router it is using. Here it is taking 3 router, here it is using 4 router, like this. But we are going to discuss in our routing protocol that one. And if we take the OSPF is going to use the metric value, that we will discuss in the next video. Anyhow, just I give you this introduction. Just remember, router is a device which used to communicate two different network. Okay, so now we will see the router modes. There are different types of mode present in the router. We are going to look that one in packet tracer also. First we will see the theory in here. After completion of theory, we will move to the lab in packet tracer. We are going to do all the modes, how it work and all that one. So now let's move to router modes. They are mainly 5 router mode. Generally we have 5 router mode. First one is known as user mode. The by default, when we open the router, it will appear. That is known as router mode. And also we call another name also is a default mode. It has two name, user mode or default mode. In this mode, we can do some basic monitoring. Means in this mode we cannot configure. If we want to configure RIP or anything, we cannot do here. This is only a small axis. Like we can say, if junior engineer is there and he is new to the company, maybe the company will not give the full access to the router. They will give only this one, so daily he can check some parameter like that. So in this only he can monitor. And how it look? This low, it look like this. Whatever router name we wrote, after that this symbol it will appear in the user mode. And we can run some commands such as ping, telnet, and var to see the version of the router, etc. Now next we will move to another mode that is known as privilege mode. In this mode we can do some monitoring as well as troubleshooting. In this mode we have two things we can do: monitoring. Here also we are doing the monitoring, but here along with the monitoring we can do troubleshooting also. And how it appear? It will appear like this symbol, the name of the router, and this symbol will come in the privilege mode. So now we will going to move to next mode after privilege mode, and before that one, what commands we are going to execute? Example, I will give you that one. In this we can run a command like clock, ping, telnet, save, show, history, etc. Means if you want to see the clock of router, we can type clock. If you want to ping one router to another router, we can do in this mode. And if we want to telnet router, we can do. And if we want to save the configuration, we can do. And show and history, whatever commands we executed in the router, if we want to see, we can type the history. In the privilege mode, we will see. And the most favorite command we can see, show IP interface brief. This is the most important command. Show, we will write SH. Show IP interface brief, show IP int int. We will write like this. I will show you in the packet tracer about this one. IP interface brief. If we write like this, it will show all the interface, whatever IP is assigned and the port is down or up, everything. So this one also we are going to execute in our privilege mode. Okay. Now we will go to global configuration mode. This is a very important mode. All configuration we are going to do here. We need to go to the global configuration mode. How we will go to global configuration mode? We will type config t. Example, if we are I am here, example, this is my router one. First we will have like this. When I put the enable, then I will go to the next mode. From the user mode I will go to the privilege mode. How it will look? It will look like this. Then if I do the config t configuration terminal, if I write this config t, then we will move in the global configuration mode and it will look like this. It will look like this. So this is a router name, whatever router name we have, this is a router name and this is the global configuration. So here we can do a router rip. Example, if I want to configure the rip, I can write router rip version 2 and no auto samurai and the network and all that one we can do. Like this we will do the configuration in the global configuration mode. So now we will see some example here about the global configuration mode, what we are going to do. Let me show you this global configuration mode here, this one. Example, rip just now as we done. So now I will move to the next one, interface mode. So what is interface mode? Example, if you want to assign the IP address to the router, we need to first go the interface mode. In this mode, we can configure the IP addresses specific, or if we want to assign the access list to the particular port, or if we are going to do the NAT network address translation, in that mode, we can do that one. In the interface means we need to assign this port to access list or to the NAT, like inbound, outbound. We will use this one. Anyhow, no issue if you don't know anything. In our coming videos, we will discuss that one. Just remember, interface mode is nothing but a mode. In that we can do the IP address. If we want to assign the IP address, we will do that one and we will do some more configuration. And how it look? It look like this. It look like this. This one like this. And how we will go means, first we need to go to the global configuration mode. After that we need to type interface and the port number, what is the port. If we are in the different port, example, if I am in the port F0/1, then I will write interface F0/1, then we will go in the that port and it look like this. And if I want to assign the IP address, if I want to assign the IP address to that particular port, I can use like this IP address and that address and subnet mask. So this will assign the IP address. And all the ports in the Cisco routers by default is shut down. We need to do no shut down to keep the port up. So port will be down by default in the Cisco router. So we will give this command to move to the port to in the up mode. Now we will go to the another mode, that is roam. Roam mode we use generally to recover the password. Example, if we forget the password and we want to recover that one, we need to go in the roam mode. And how it look? It look like this. And how we will go in the roam mode? We will do in the packet tracer the practical, but this is just theory. How we will do means we need to power on the router and press control plus break. Then we will enter in the ROM mode. Okay. So now I will open the packet tracer and we will see this practical in the packet tracer. So let me open my packet tracer now. Then we will see this one. Let me open, change the new one. I will do the, open the new file. This is a new file. So I will take one router. Let me take this one. This is example, and I will increase the font size. I will do the zoom in so you will have the something bigger. This is a router, okay? This is generally we have one router, and this one is the router. If we double click this one, we will see, we will go in the command mode in the packet tracer. So I will do that one. I will double click this one. Now we are here, and after that we need to click CLI. Then we are inside the router. I will take this one. Let me maximize this window little more because maybe this will not come in my capture screen. Anyhow, let's see this one. I will write no. First we need to write no, then enter. This is the router user mode. As I told you, this is a user mode. If we want to move from user mode to privilege mode, we will write ENT in, then we will move. But before that one, we can do some comments. I will type the comments and I will show you. I will write here, let me write the comment. Let's see. I will write here to show that one version. I will write show VER. This will show the version. See, this is here we can see the version. What is version is showing here. I will make this zoom in. See, this is the version. It is showing that version. And then we can go to the next mode. To go in the next mode, we need to write EN. With this one we will move to the privilege mode. Here we can see our favorite comment, show IP interface brief. So there are so many comments we can perform here to see. This is used to monitor as well as to we can say monitor and troubleshooting. So I will write show IP interface brief. So it will show all the IP because I did not assign any IP here. That's why it is not showing any IP here. See here. This is interface is down here. Nothing is selected. Let me show you here. And see here, this one. No IP assigned and port is down. This is also down. This is also down. And all is down because we did not assign. Just we are seeing this one. So this is our privilege mode. If I want to move from the privilege mode to the another mode, that is global configuration mode, what I will write? I will write here config t. Then now I am in the configuration mode. This is a configuration mode. In configuration mode, we can do any configuration router rip. If you want to do configuration of router, let me write some small like router rip version 2 no auto summary, and then network. We need to write whatever network we need to give here, but we did not assign any IP address, anything, so I don't want to give any network. But this is the configuration mode. We can do any configuration here. Okay, so now I will move to another one. Before going this, I will go to the interface mode. I want to show you interface mode. Before, how I can go interface mode? First I need to go to global configuration mode. From that one I can go to interface mode. So I will write global configuration mode. I will write like this, config t. Then I am here inside the global configuration mode. If I want to move to interface INT, then what is the interface? Example F0/0. Then I am here in F0/0. So this is global configuration mode. Here I can assign the IP address, any IP address. Let me assign any IP. I will assign as IP address like 10.1.1.1, and then subnet mask 255.255.255. I will assign .0.0 because this is class A. So this is subnet mask. Then we don't forget to write no shed, because all Cisco router by default is shed on. So we need to write no shed. And see, this is changing the interface, and it is going here. This interface 0/0 is changed state to up, and means it is now, before it is done, now it is changed to up because we give no shutdown. So this is the interface mode. With this one we can assign the IP address. Now we will go to the roam mode. How we will go in the roam mode? We need to reload or restart this one, or press switch off and switch on, and then press control break. So I will reload this one. ReLOAD, reload. Yes, then confirm. Yes, it is reloading. Now we need to do control break. If we press control break, see, now it came in the roam mode. The roam mode is this one. I will show you here. This is our roam mode. This is the roam mode. This mode we use to recover the password. So see, this is roam mode, and we use this one as a password recovery mode. So this is about our video, how, what is roam mode and what is your user mode, privilege mode, and all this one. So next video we are going to start about the packet tracer series, about router RIP and OSPF, EIGRP, and all this one. And after that we will have BGP also in our packet tracer series very soon. So thank you very much for seeing our video. Next video we will have very soon. See you, bye.